I've been having some Shimano Ultegra problems. For those of you that don't know, I have Shimano Ultegra mechanical discs, so R8020, so R8020. And over here, Shimano actually sent me this part on warranty. It's for the left shifter, so the shifter that shifts between the big and the little ring. It was clicking. It was like kind of shifting. I tried rerouting everything, but as you guys know, I'm a mechanic at my bike shop. One of the other mechanics said he ran into this problem before, and he said, "Oh, they're just effective if they do that. You try and shift it, and you get a little like click, or it almost doesn't shift." So apparently, the warranty on Ultegra is 2 years. So this is what I got,
which is really, really cool. Here, put it out of the bag, I can do it with one hand. So here it is, an all-new R8020 leather, which I think looks pretty sweet. You can take it out of the bag.
Here we go. It's brand new, all-new Ultegra leather. Oh. But the thing is, at my work, I have all the stuff to do it. I don't really have the bleeding stuff, you know. Yeah, you know, I'm kind of new to disc brakes. So, yeah, my bike's got like 600 miles on it or something like that. I'm going to go repair it at work. And then I'm going to get back to you guys and we're going to talk about this. Oh, also they sent me a new cable, which is cool. Alright guys, fast forward a couple weeks, we're here, sorry for the delay, just got a couple busy with a couple of things. The new shifter is installed and it is fantastic, and I just want to take a moment here to give a huge thank you to Shimano USA for taking care of me and for honoring the 2-year Ultegra warranty. This is Ultegra R8020, like I said, with the mechanical group set with hydraulic disc brakes. So that is what is here, and it's perfect. And don't worry, I glocked this. Thank you to my mom for getting me this shirt. The shirt's awesome. I like guacamole. More of a recovery food. Don't do that before you go out for a bike ride, because you'll feel a little bit's okay, but you'll feel a little bit sluggish. You want to have carbs before and then have stuff like this afterwards. But yeah, the old one I have in this box, which I'm actually gonna mail back. Part of the deal was to add 2 months to mail back the old shifter, and it's in this bag right here. I showed it to you earlier in the video, so. Well, you've already seen the old one. The new one's on the bike. But yeah, this shifter, the old one, as you can see, it's in the bag. I just don't wanna take it out, because it's a little bit dirty, because it has a little bit of mineral oil. For those of you that don't know, with Shimano hydraulic disc brakes, you gotta use Shimano mineral oil to do it, and it's pretty good. And then you just clean it off. You gotta spray it down with isopropyl alcohol. I'm not gonna try and do a tutorial. I might do a tutorial video later. Let me guys know in the comments below if you want me to do something like that, because there are already some out there, and some of them are clear, some of them are not. I think it depends on what kind of bleeding equipment you have. Well, I kind of learned. Shout out to my boy Wes. He is awesome. He is one of the mechanics that works with me at my bike shop. And he walked me through it. He's a mountain biker. He's constantly doing downhill stuff with his Yeti. So he is awesome. He showed me. He walked me through this. So now if you're like, hey, can you bleed my brakes? I could be like, absolutely, which is great. But here's the thing. It made it a little bit harder because, you know, I had to take it off. So when you're removing the shifter completely, that's why I had to bleed the brake. And it was the front brake because the left shifter. And there was so much air in there because I had to replace it. So it was the BH90, which is a Shimano part, it's a brake hose. You gotta cut it off and you gotta put the thing on. And it's funny, guys were like, hey, like, why don't you just rewrap the bars? Like, put some new bar tape on there. But the thing is, I love new bar tape, makes it feel like an entirely new bike, but this bar tape is still perfectly good, I think that. So I'm gonna leave it be for right now. But I'm thinking about putting some light blue, because if you guys can see what I've done to the bike, you guys may have seen if you follow me on Instagram. I have blue caps, Supercast caps, blue Supercast cages, So I'm going for kind of the blue accents. Like, you know, some people have the silver or gray McLarens and they want to make them more exciting, so they put like light blue brake calipers. I think that's a really cool look as well. So that's kind of like what I'm going for on this bike. And I flipped the stem around to the negative position and I slammed it just to space. You don't want to slam it too far unless you're running a really deep plug, or else you're going to damage this and that's really dangerous. So don't slam your stem, you know, below like this amount unless you have a deep plug. And try switching around over in the negative position. For it just changes the look of the bike. I think the bike looks so much better in the negative position. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I'm so happy with this. This is great. And I'm going to mail this old shifter back, which had this problem. I was telling you where it would click and then it like wouldn't quite shift, which is really weird. And one of my mechanics said that he had seen that problem before. It was an R8000 or R8020 shifter. And you just have to claim warranty on it and send it back. And Shimano will honor the warranty because they'll probably figure it out, you know, within, you know, the first little bit of riding it. So you'll figure it out and they'll honor the warranty, which is really, really good. Huge shout out to Shimano USA for that. And it's just, it shifts so well. I love Ultegra. Ultegra is fantastic. I know I talked about how great Sora was. But the thing is, I didn't even have a full Sora group set. It was kind of a melting pot of Vero cranks and things like that. So, you know, it depends. I haven't tried the full Sora 3500 group set. But the thing is, Ultegra is just so nice. Like, I don't know how much better Durace is than that. People say that 105 and, you know, Durace ride the same. But the shifts get a little bit nicer. I think that's what it is. With this, the shifts are definitely super nice. And so happy with it. Definitely keep your drivetrain tuned. I've kept my drivetrain tuned. You got to maintain it or else it's going to skip gears and stuff like that. You want to maintain the cable tension and all that. Let me know if you guys want an instructional video on how to do that. And if you do that, your drivetrain is going to be, if you had a poorly maintained Durace drivetrain versus this with a really well maintained Ultegra drivetrain, this is going to be even better, which is really good. So like I said, I'm going to mail this back to Shimano. That was part of the deal. They mailed me a return label. So I'm just going to put it in my mailbox and mail it back to them. So they made everything super easy and concise and easy to follow, which is really good. And I just want to say how happy I am with this. And I'm happy that I got to learn how to bleed brakes. It is different. It is a little bit of a pain if you had rim brakes and you could just throw a new cable in there. Like I said, I can do an entire video on disc brakes versus rim brakes. I just don't want to be unfair because I want to make sure I've had enough miles with a disc brake bike to really form an opinion on that. I've had about 700 miles on this bike. Not all of them logged on Strava, most of them logged on Strava. A little less than 700 logged on Strava. So I'll call it 700 miles on this bike. And it has some advantages. You can run wider tires, which is really cool, which I haven't done yet just because I want to wear these out. You know, don't just, you know, throw out the tires that come with the bike, use them. And then, you know, I was getting punctures, it's a little frustrating, but here's a tip. Fill up your tires, especially if you live in a cold climate. Fill up your tires outside, or maybe drain them a little bit, then fill them up outside so the air pressure is going to be the same, so you won't have that diffusion. Well, this definitely is a skinny, like a narrow, not in width, just the actual of the material. If you were to take the tire and sort of feel how much material there is between the inner tube and the road, there's not much. Or if you were to take something like a gator skin, there's a lot, and they give you Kevlar and things like that, which I think makes for a better riding experience because you don't have that, you know, constant fear of like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get a flat. You don't have to go tubeless, because tubeless is like, tubeless is a whole nother video. I haven't tried it. People try to get me to go tubeless. My opinion for right now is tubeless is for mountain bikers and I don't need it. That's what I think for right now. Maybe my mind could be changed. Maybe my opinion could be swayed. But yeah, I haven't showed you guys my bike in a little while actually. And this isn't the same white fence. I made a video introducing this bike, which is behind a white fence. This is a different white fence. I'm in a different part of my property, but it's awesome. I love this bike. It's been fantastic. There are pros and cons to disc brakes. I think they look pretty cool. At first I wasn't sure, Sorry, I'm just gonna sit down. First, I wasn't sure, but honestly, I think disc brakes look pretty cool in the Ultegra form. I don't like the way the SRAM ones look. I like the SRAM ones because they're different, but I feel like they just look kind of boring because I'm constantly seeing bikes with SRAM group sets in the shop, so maybe I guess it gets a little bit boring. But I think Ultegra looks better than Durace and 105 rotors. I love the Ultegra rotors, not just because I have an Ultegra, but I just think they look cool. I think they look so cool. So yes, I'm definitely super happy with this bike, super happy with Shimano's customer service. Gonna send this shifter back to them. And I wanna thank you guys all for bearing with me. I've been a little bit busy with a couple other things. I'm doing my best to get you guys the best videos that I can. And I post Instagram stories sometimes when I go out for rides. So definitely, I'll put my Instagram in the description if you wanna follow me on there. And I just want, also the frame tape, before we go, the frame tape has been very good. It's kept the paint from deteriorating. Definitely check out frame tape. That is not just for mountain bikers. It's really cool to protect your frame from the vulnerable areas. So definitely check that out. And thank you guys so much for supporting me and for being here. I'm so lucky to have you guys in front of me. This is so awesome. And new shifters on. So grateful for this bike. So grateful for you guys. If you guys want to see more cycling related videos, a couple videos here and there about how veganism relates to cycling, and a couple nature inspired videos, definitely be sure to subscribe if you want to do that. And thank you for being here, guys. I appreciate you. See ya.